Welcome to Kennedy Now, a regular look inside activities and progress at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida and by KSC teams around the country. A United Launch Alliance Atlas V roared off Launch Complex 41 on January 23rd to lift NASA's latest tracking and data relay satellite into orbit high above Earth. Weighing 7,600 pounds, the TDRS-L communication spacecraft was placed into a geosynchronous transfer orbit by the Atlas booster. When it settles into its permanent orbit about 22,300 miles above the Earth, the satellite will send commands and data back and forth between ground stations and the International Space Station, the Hubble Space Telescope, and NASA's fleet of Earth-orbiting observatories. A liftoff of a different kind excited engineers when the experimental Morpheus lander leapt off the Earth and steered itself to a gentle landing on a landing field strewn with hazards to simulate landing on another world. Morpheus does not carry any people and flies itself through an automated approach and landing sequence. Once the checkout flights are complete, the full-length flights with a specialized system called ALHAT on board will be the first to show that the lander can detect and avoid dangerous objects and still make a safe landing. The lander technologies are scalable and could support future robotic missions and eventually human lander designs. Sierra Nevada Corporation announced its intention in January to launch the first orbital mission of its Dream Chaser spacecraft from the Florida spaceport atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket. The company intends to process the winged spacecraft at Kennedy facilities, including the high bay of the historic operations and checkout building. Sierra Nevada's plan calls for the Dream Chaser to glide back to Earth and land at Kennedy's shuttle landing facility. The mission will not carry astronauts, but Sierra Nevada is developing the Dream Chaser to carry people into low Earth orbit. This has been Kennedy Now. Thanks for watching.